What's going on, guys? This is Cooper MTG, and today we are bringing you a Khans of Tarkir booster box opening. So let's go ahead and open up this beautiful box right here.
You don't have to smell like fresh plastic in the morning.
Let's zoom in here. Alright. Pack number one. There we go. Pack into it.
And this time you have to read the rares.
So I'll go over the uncommons and the rares. First uncommon is a Stubborn Denial. Armament Corpse. Monastery Swiftspear, very good card, and our rare is High Sentinels of Arashin. 4 mana, 3 colorless, 1 white. Flying High Sentinels of Arashin gets +1/+1 for each creature you control with a +1/+1 counter on it. And for 3 colors and a white, you can put a +1/+1 counter on target creature, and it is a 3/4. No foil. But I really do like the land art for these cards.
Yeah, it's pretty cool for this guy. I like
it. Pretty cool. See. Oh. Yeah, I picked it off perfectly. A Blowing Saddle Brute. Suspension Field, very good. Warden of the Eye, and our rare is a Thousand Winds. In one of our earlier Khans of Tarkir videos, I went over this card, so if you want to see it, it's kind of boring.
You are so lazy.
It's also in the dual deck, so you should have seen it by now. I'll go over the really good cards.
You're so lazy.
I'll do a second booster box video in 3 parts, and I'll go over the rares in a lot greater detail.
You lazy, lazy butt.
A Ruthless Ripper. Dragon's Eye Savants, Mardu Rough Rider, and our rare is Trail of Mystery with a foil. Nothing. Just kidding.
Only I have the telepathic powers to tell him there's going to be a foil.
Okay, will there be a foil in this pack?
I can't tell until you get to the rare.
Alright, because you can see the side. First uncommon, Dragon Grip, Mardu Charm, Abzan Falconer, and our rare is a Mythic Ashcloud Phoenix, 2 colors, 2 red. Flying, when Ashcloud Phoenix dies, return to the battlefield face down. You can morph it for 4 colorless and 2 red. When Ashcloud Phoenix is turned face up, it deals 2 damage to each player. Very interesting card. First Mythic of our box. No fetch lands yet, but, you know, I'm sure there's 10 of them left in the box.
The ironic thing about this is that we've gotten almost every single one-colored mythic from Khans of Tarkir.
Chief of the Scale, Swarm of Bloodflies, High Spire Mantis, and our rare is Sultai Ascendancy, decent card, and a foil, Secret Plans. The artwork looks amazing on that in foil. Very cool.
Don't be worth so much money.
For a good card. Speaking of cards being worth money, Stoke the Flames is currently around $4.
Super cool, guys.
That's a lot of money for an uncommon. I did not do a good job there. Karu Bloodsucker. Secret Plans non-foil. Windstorm, and our rare is Altar of the Brood. Not a very good card.
It would be pretty cool looking in foil, though.
Anything, and pretty much any non-black card looks cool in foil.
That's something against black cards?
No. Misfire Weaver, Incremental Growth. Horde Ambusher, and our rare is Ugin's Nexus, a mythic. 5 colorless. If a player would begin an extra turn, that player skips that turn instead. If Ugin's Nexus would be put into a graveyard from battlefield instead, exiled and take an extra turn after this one, It's a legendary artifact. So originally I was thinking you could play two of them, and so you'd have to sacrifice one of them, but then you would have to skip your extra turn that you'd take. So if we were, your opponent can't take extra turns, that'd be cool. What if there's a card that, like, your opponents can't take turns? That'd be really funny.
That would just get rid of the point of the game.
Become you immense.
Can't take turns.
Water Whirl. Mardu Rough Rider, and the rare is Narset Enlightened Master.
That's our second one.
Third mythic of the box. Three colors, one blue, one red, one white. First strike, hexproof. Whenever Narset Enlightened Master attacks, exile the top four cards of your library. Until end of turn, you may cast non-creature cards exiled with Narset this turn without paying their mana costs. Very cool card.
We're just doing so well today. Three mythics. And then the rest of the packs, like, all the other piles are just going to be poop.
Just as long as you get three fetch lands out of here, I'm good. Timely Horde Mate, Incremental Growth, Witness of the Ages, and our rare is a Bloodstained Mire. Very cool. Fetch land.
Very cool for a swag. I like it. Uh-huh.
If it's a fetch land, it's worth something to me. If it's not a fetch land, I don't want it.
Unless it's like a Sarkhan or a Sorin. Because you know Sarkhan's $30 now?
Maybe 25, I don't know. Mardu Blazebringer. Watcher of the Roost, Tomb of the Spirit Dragon, and our rare is Jeering Instigator. I have not seen or played with a lot of these cards, so definitely after this video I will be making a deck. I have, however, played Sealed once and drafted.
He's addicted to Mardu.
Once. Actually, I played Mardu once, and I played Teemer the other time. Actually, I've drafted three times. Drafted two times. Played Teemer both times. Abzan, Battle Priest. Merak, Nightblade. Sultai Charm, and the rare is Sage of the Inward Eye. And there is a foil. Master of Pearls. That is our foil rare for the box. Sadly, not a good card.
But it looks cool.
Actually, the pearls
really
cool. Look pretty cool.
It looks like he's like pinging a bunch of shiny balls at people. Shiny ball attack, go! Waha! How do you know we're only gonna get one foil rare?
Dazzling Ramparts, you only get one per box. Take Up Arms, Warden of the Eye, and our rare is a Wooded Foothills. Fetch land.
Only one more and you get your gold! I get a foil Wooded Fletch.
Foothills. All we've gotten... Actually, no, we got a Flooded Strand recently. We have not gotten a Windswept Heath, which is the white and green one. Sorry for that bump there.
It's worth the least.
Actually, Bloodstained Mire, I think, is worth the least. Goblin Slide, Abzan Charm, Bear's Companion, and the rare, another Sultai Ascendancy. These tendencies are just all around very good, at least in limited.
Do you even know what like you're talking about when you say limited?
Yeah, you know what limited is?
Nope.
Sealed or draft. Mardu Blazebringer, Briber's Purse, Warname Aspirant, and our rare, Howl of the Horde. Is there a foil?
Nah.
You're correct.
My secret.
Secret plans.
What? No. I like to finding out.
Winter Flame. Karu Bloodsucker. Teemer Charger. And the rare is a Bloodsucked Champion. Very cool card. One black. Bloodsucked Champion. Can't
He's
block.
He's actually reading the card. What do you know?
Well, it's a good one, so I'm going to read it. Raid. One colorless, one black. Return him to the battlefield. Activate this ability only if you attack with a creature this turn. Wow, that mountain looks very cool.
Very cool, very swag. I like it. I wonder if you said that without, like, a weird voice. Like, very cool, very swag, I like it. It doesn't have the same ring.
Yeah. River Wheel Aerialists, Sandstep Citadel, Quiet Contemplation, and the rare is a Jeskai Ascendancy.
Third Ascendancy of the box.
I hope that the Ascendancies don't turn into the Primordials like from Gatecrash, where they're really only good for Limited and Commander.
Or like Dictates.
Binding Spray. Yeah. I mean, but I think they're really good. Like, the Mardu Ascendancy will be good in, like, the Goblin Rattlemaster decks. And I don't know, I haven't really played other ones. Mystic Monastery, Bearish Companion, in the rare, a Rakshasa Death Dealer.
And there's a foil.
Really cool card. A black and a green. You can pay a black and a green to either give him +2/+2 or regenerate him. And he's a 2/2.
And there's a foil.
And a foil Abomination of Gadul.
Looks really weird.
Which looks kind of funky. The art.
It's like a poop. Like a bunch of poop on the ground.
So I think we passed halfway at this point. So we're two fetch lands.
Three mythics.
Kintree Invocation. This is really good with the Rotting Mastodon, the 2/8. Because you get an 8/8 for 2 mana. Kind of ridiculous. Cranial Archive, Monastery Swift Spear, and our rare is
a poop.
Ankle Shanker. I really like this card.
I just like that name, Ankle Shanker.
It's not a super good card necessarily, but it's really fun.
This is the name. Here's Ankle Shanker.
Dragon Grip, Mardu Charm. Despise, very good card, and a rare. Meandering Tower Shell, this is one of my least favorite rares to get, with a foil Sage Eye Harrier.
And you can tell from his voice that he's only good, and he's like, and
you said that.
You need to do that thing that you did last time when you get a bad card, and you just do the really weird voice. What was that? For Nyx, I think?
I've not actually uploaded that video yet. I'm too lazy.
You lazy bummer!
Arc Lightning, very good card. Teemer Charm, Ride Down in the rare, is a Teemer Ascendancy,
foil.
And a foil Jeskai Elder, and this is not a bad card at all.
You're so lazy.
But it looks really cool.
I need a cool.
You want to read them all? You're making me do it in one old video, and I want to keep it under 3 hours long. I'm not going to read every single card. Stubborn Denial. Roar of Challenge, Heart Pierce Pro, first time I've seen this, and a rare, Dig Through Time, very cool card. 15 packs left. Blinding Spray, Jeskai Elder, Nomad Outpost, and the rare. Mindswipe. Very interesting card. Could see some play. The ability certainly is good, even if they pay the mana to not counter the spell. It still deals the damage to them. Master the Way. Swarm of Bloodflies. Dead Drop in the rare. Creator's Clause. Very similar to Mindswipe. No foil there.
Are we getting mythics?
We're not
I don't
really
care if it's all based on not mythics. I just like them. They're shiny and cool and beautiful.
Burn Away. Set Adrift. Tomb of the Spirit Dragon. And the rare is Rakshasa Vizier.
E-ug.
Promo rare. So we have 12 packs left. I'm going to start opening from the bottom of the stack.
Start from the bottom of the stack. From
the bottom of the whole Kintree Invocation. Sultai Flare. Teemer Charger. And our rare. A Windswept Heath. As I said earlier, this was the only one that we haven't gotten, and we just got it. So, very cool.
And that's the third one. We're so happy. Now we don't need to get any more of those. And we can get mythics!
I'd rather get fishlands than mythics unless it's
like
Sarkin or Sorin.
I don't know. I wouldn't mind getting some of the
Chief of the Edge. War of Challenge. Heir of the Wild. And our rare. Kiru Spell Snatcher. Opened a foil one of these, but not super duper good. No foil. I didn't open from the bottom there. That's the problem. Bottom of the stack.
Well, does it matter if you open it from the bottom or the top? I mean, honestly. Because either way, you're going to still get the same cards.
Dazzling Ramparts? It's good luck, dude. Wow. Seeker of the Way. Despise. Really nice card. And our rare. The another Jeering Instigator. I'm gonna open from the middle. And do this. I think we've opened three Sarkins. No Sorins. But three Sarkins. Not complaining or anything. Timely Hordemate, Ruthless Ripper, Seeker of the Way, and our rare. A Dune Blast. One of those, choose one creature, destroy the rest. Not that I'd ever play it. Because I'm not crazy.
Well, it could be a game-winning card, honestly.
Yeah, it could. But doesn't mean I'm going to play it. Arc Lightning. Cranial Archive. Jeskai Elder. And the rare. Another Ugin's Nexus. Oh, boy.
Two? Oh, golly. That's going to be like the Maze's End now. Gosh darn it.
Yeah, I'm going to open a foil one.
Yeah, you want a Maze's End?
Burn Away. Jeskai Charm. Secret Plans. The Rare. Dune Blast. Oh, boy.
Another one?
So this stack side, we've opened a Windswept Heath and an Ugin's Nexus. The Windswept Heath, obviously, is the good one. So that's kind of like one per 12 packs on the Fetchlands. Scion of Glaciers, Teemer Charm, Heart Piercer Bow, the rare, Icy Blast. And a second foil rare, Sage of the Inward Eye.
Who said, you know, you only get one foil rare?
I guess maybe you can get more than one foil rare in these boxes now.
Only get one foil rare. Always been getting more than one foil rare.
No, we haven't. Dookus Head. Mystic Monastery. Death Frenzy. I've never seen that card. Tusk Guard Captain in the rare. A Savage Knuckleblade.
Yay.
Very cool. Very swag. I like it.
Read it. You thought it was a foil fetch land.
Yeah. Savage Knuckleblade. One green, one blue, one red. You can pay two and a green to give him plus two, only activate that once. Two and a blue to return it to his owner's hand, and a red to give it haste. And it's a 4/4, and that's probably why Stoke of Flames has gone up, because it deals with the Savage Knuckleblade. Nothing else really does. You really have to kill it as soon as it comes out. Or when they don't have mana open. Hordling Outburst, Seek the Horizon, Abzan Falconer, the rare, a Hooded Hydra, X, 2 green, Hooded Hydra enters battlefield with X, +1/+1 counters on it. When Hooded Hydra dies, put a 1/1 green snake creature token on the battlefield for each +1/+1 counter on it. You can morph it for 5, 3 colors, 2 green. As Hooded Hydra is turned face up, put 5+1/+1 counters on it.
Can't really complain with that.
You know, I love me some $5 mythics. Yeah, I do love me some fetch lands.
There's nothing wrong with getting $5 mythics.
Mardu Charm. Ice Feather Aven. This card is very good. Murderous Cut and the rare. Butcher of the Horde. A very nice card.
And a foil?
Wow. A foil mythic. Zergo Helm Smasher.
Wait, what?
Now, unfortunately...
Yes, this is the one I wanted to.
Unfortunately, he was printed in the dual decks in foil, so his value is not super good. But anyway, it's very
cool. Foil mythic, shut up!
Very cool.
You're not even gonna read him?
He's in the dual decks.
Sure.
I'd read the new cards. It's like, the dual decks has been out for like a month or something.
Dude.
At least. Venerable Lamassu, Pine Walker, never seen that card. Raider Spoils, and our rare is Deflecting Palm. Do we have a foil?
Yes, we do have a foil.
Citizen's Pet. Gotta get those foils. Foil commons. Anyway. There's a foil polluted delta in here. So.
What's that, like $90?
Yeah. From Onslaught, it's. Might be upwards of 200, but I'm not quite sure. Abzan Battle Priest, Water Whirl, Frontier Bivouac, and our rare is Mardu Ascendancy.
That's not a bad
thing. So, guys, let's review what we got here.
That was good.
That was good, which is fetch lands and
mythics.
Mythics. And foil mythics.
Foil mythic. Singular. Get your grammar right.
Zergo Helm Smasher foil. Hooded Hydra. Ugin's Nexus. Narset. Ugin's Nexus. Ash Cloud Phoenix. Windswept Heat, Wooded Foothills, Bloodstained Mire, and my hand. Anyways, guys, that was Cooper NDG bringing you a Khans of Tarkir booster box opening. Make sure to leave a big thumbs up in the comment section. Leave a big thumbs up below, and let us know what you think in the comment section below. As always, subscribe, and thanks for watching.